It's been great. You know, it's part of our Gopher Road trip, which we're doing yesterday and today. We'll do it again in 2 weeks. And then we did the first stab at it was last year. And it's a great chance to get out to greater Minnesota, see fans, show appreciation, and tell our story.
What kind of response have you gotten so far on the trip?
It's been terrific. The numbers here are great, and the numbers everywhere we've been, you know, we're getting about 200 people every time we're at a function. So it's been very good. This is our fifth stop in 2 days.
How's the bus ride been?
Very good. Humorous.
Who's the biggest clown on the bus?
Oh, gosh, a good question. Probably Mike Grimm, our play-by-play. There's been some other runner-ups that we've had a good time with.
What are we looking forward to next year with the Gophers?
Well, we've had a good year. You know, we won 8 Big Ten championships, and want to do that and more. Or, you know, you always can't control that. But, you know, I feel like in a lot of ways we're building some programs, which is great. Football's getting better and better. Richard with basketball has done a phenomenal job. New women's basketball coach. Hockey's going to be good. So the main thing we've got to do is to raise money for some where we're behind in some of our physical plans.
That's right, Ben. And what do you know about St. Cloud?
Well, I've actually been catching up with the bus. I started speaking a little bit earlier, so I had to catch up and Coach O'Brien and I. But we've had a great trip, and it's been enjoyable, getting a great opportunity to meet all the Gopher fans throughout the state. And it's been a lot of fun. And you know, thanking them for all their support, because I always say it's their athletic program and certainly their football team.
I know you were just in town a little bit ago. Tell us a little bit about what brought you here a couple weeks ago.
Well, Tim Hennon organized an event here, I guess it was 2 weeks ago, and it was just you know, a great evening, and you know, we did some things with Epilepsy and Epilepsy Foundation, and it was just a good experience. We met a lot of great people, and there's a lot of great people here in St. Cloud, you know, very caring people, so it was great to be there at that time, and it's great to be here today.
Tell us a little bit about TCF Bank Stadium. You're going to have some new digs, at least in a way, some new seats, some heated field. Is that going to affect your team?
Well, really not too much, because you know, we play late or earlier. We're done earlier than the Vikings, so the heated coils and things really don't affect us as much. But you know, it's great for our fans, because they can come down, so to speak, for a doubleheader if they want to. So I think it's great for the state, and we look forward to building that relationship and working together to make good things happen.
One more. What are you looking forward to next season? What can fans look forward to from the Gopher football team?
Well, I think just looking forward to, it's a new year, new team, and watching them grow. And we've been able to continue to get better, and I expect us to be better this year.
Well, you know, that's a loaded question, but, you know, I just had a great time. I had a great time as an undergrad, and, you know, basketball was great. I experienced a lot of mixed emotions, but for the most part, I just love the community, I love the school, love wearing the colors, and just really fell in love and got my master's here, and now I'm working for the department, it's almost like a dream come true, but I really enjoy it. So,
as a former player, what do you think of Richard Pitino's performance in his first season? Obviously, they had a lot of success.
Well, you know, for me, first of all, you know, I'm a big U of M guy, so being able to see the guys and their progress on the court for me was probably the biggest thing. As far as Richard and his leadership, man, he's a young guy. We know he's not going to be outworked. We know he's going to elevate the program, and for me, being an alum, that's the most important thing. You know, coaches come and go. Hopefully we can keep them for as long as possible, but, you know, you have to have that understanding. But I really just love the fact that he's not going to be outworked, and he really likes his place, and he's really embraced, and that really allowed the easy way out. And I think he's going to have a lot of success, so I'm excited.